It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Pain Capital Management here in New York City.
This is Courtney Dominguez, financial advisor and CFP at Pain Capital Management with your weekly market update. The global markets came in like a lion this week and went out like a lamb. The markets capped its multi-week rally with the NASDAQ Composite Index exceeding 10,000 for the first time, setting all-time record highs at the same time the S&P 500 Index erased its losses made in the early days of the pandemic and turned positive for the year. The rally from the lows of March was the best 50-day stretch in the history of the stock market. However, rallies of this magnitude are always vulnerable to a pullback or a correction, and this rally found its catalyst for a correction in the recent headlines. According to Johns Hopkins University, the coronavirus death toll climbed past 110,000, while states from Florida to California reported spikes in cases of new infections. This was then followed by a warning from Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell that the economy's recovery from the pandemic-fueled recession will be slow and uneven. However, the news from the chairman wasn't all bad. He said while financial conditions have improved, they, the Fed, will continue to use all of the tools at their disposal to support the recovery, including backstopping the bond market by purchasing treasury bonds and mortgage-backed securities. He also stated that he and the central banks weren't thinking about raising interest rates, saying he intends to keep rates low until the end of 2022. Keep in mind, low rates are not only good for loans like mortgages, but also equate to higher PE ratios for stocks that went on sale this week. Moreover, the pullback this week came after the best 50-day rally in market history. Seven other times since 1957, when the market gained at least 20% over a 50-day period, the market gained at least 5.2% in the year that followed. And don't forget about yield. Stocks yield three times the yield on the 10-year Treasury bond. You're getting paid to wait. Markets also anticipate future conditions after weighing the worries that headlines and data convey. Corrections come and go fast in a secular bull market. Don't allow the short-term noise from the media to keep you from gains that come in a big booming bull market. Now, if you're sitting there wondering, do I have a portfolio appropriate for my goals to my family's risk tolerance? Well, why wonder? Give us a call or text 844-752-6692. That's 844-752-6692. Again, this is Courtney Dominguez with your weekly market update.